Tira.
David, Courtney, Steph, Boris, Rachel, Chase. Heath and I set a vision about 6 months ago for this conference. And there was two things we wanted it to accomplish. We wanted it to look like the company we've grown to become, and we wanted it to be small and intimate so it can reflect our culture, and our culture is all about people and about people connecting with each other. Mm-hmm. And I mean, it's a thing in the world for CEOs to set visions and for executive teams to set visions, and then the reality never reflects the vision. That's just the reality of the world. We are overwhelmed that your reality of what you've created here is so far above our vision. Either we are very poor at setting vision, or you are very great at creating a conference that accomplishes this. Look around us. We're all together. We're together in an intimate setting so that we can connect as people, but everything I see reflects the company we've become. And so your reality is greater than our vision, and a big round of applause to the whole team. You're here. I'm going to give you a formal CEO address. It's only about 25 minutes. I have two guest speakers. It won't be that long. But before they do that, I have two things I want to say. And the first thing I want to say is, how great is it to be together? Like, to actually be together as human beings. Forget the business stuff. Just as human beings, to be able to talk to each other and connect with each other and to be together with each other. So please, look to your left, look to your right. Shake hands with somebody, connect with somebody. This is a chance for us to connect together. Nika, it's good to meet you. And enjoy the fact that we're together as people, that we can connect as people, that we can be here together as people. The second thing I want to say, the second part of my opening remarks is this: when's the last time that any of you had the opportunity to exercise your public speaking skills?
Assuming we had some.
Assuming you had some in the first place. I don't know what the list is, but I know the list is something like drowning in an underwater cave, an IRS audit, and public speaking are like the three things that people are most afraid of in the world. And public speaking is always on that list. I am so nervous to give this talk today. I have not done a public speech since February of 2020. It's, what's that, like almost 18 months. And so bear with me if my voice cracks, or bear with me if I just flat out stop and have to gather myself. I'm very, very nervous. Okay, we're gonna do a formal CEO address. You ready? 25 minutes. Yes, please. Good day, everyone. My name is Bob Irwin, CEO of Decisions. It's great to see everyone gathered here today. And I'm excited about the time we get to spend together as colleagues, as friends, as coworkers, and most of all, as people, as human beings connecting with each other. Customer experience is at the center of everything we do here at Decisions, and our customer relationships wind and wend and weave through the fabric of our business. Our customers use Decisions, one complete solution for all your software needs, to write applications and build automations. For example, Prime Lending, Runa HR, and Fidelity Life use Decisions to write applications. Prime Lending used Decisions to write a custom loan processing application. Runa HR used Decisions to write a custom payroll approval application. And Fidelity Life used Decisions to write a custom systems integration application. Coke Supply and Trading, the Helmsley Trust, and Home Care Pulse used Decisions to build automations. Coke Supply and Trading built an automation to give real-time risk data to their commodities traders. Home Care Pulse built an automation to turn a manual Excel-based quality control process into a fully automated and scheduled job. And the Helmsley Charitable Trust built an automation to cut their monthly reconciliation process from 20 days to 2 hours. Whether you use Decisions to write applications or use Decisions to build automations, we are glad you're here with us today, and your experience is at the center of everything we do. Allow me to introduce myself to you. I recently celebrated my 1-year anniversary here at Decisions. My favorite Decision swag is my 1-year anniversary jacket, but I'm so nervous and it's so warm in here that I'm not putting it on, so here it is. But I recently celebrated my 1-year anniversary, and I'm looking at, when I was looking for a new job, I was looking for a growth company. I was looking for in a growth industry. I was looking for a company with a great product. Boy, did I find that here. But I was looking for a company with great people, and I really found that here, and a real and true commitment to customers. And any customer here today knows that any Decisions person they talk to is committed to their success and committed to the future of their business. I'm a proud graduate of The Ohio State University. I'm a season ticket holder, and I still go to every game. Go Bucks. And in the fourth part, I am in the fourth part of my 5-part career. In part one, I was a sales and marketing professional, starting with a long stint at IBM, where I learned the importance of living your values. At IBM, our values were respect for the individual, excellence, and superior customer service. In part two of my career, I was a technology executive, a chief information officer, a CIO for JP Morgan Chase and Bear Stearns. In other words, I've been a customer like you, and I pride myself on looking at the world from our customer's point of view. In part three of my career, I was, and I learned how to be, painfully many times, learned how to be a CEO. As CEO of Sterling Commerce, CEO of TDCI, and CEO of EMS Software, I learned how to balance aggressive growth with customer experience and how important both are to each other. As the CEO of Tango, which was the hardest job of my life, I learned the real and powerful force of people and culture. Our people transformed the culture of Tango, which transformed the company, reversing years of customer neglect and revenue decline into customer delight and growth. Now, in the fourth part of my 5-part career as the CEO of Decisions, I've found my home. I've found my home as a human, I've found my home as a person, and I've found my home as a CEO. Decisions, one complete solution for all your software needs, is the global software standard for the Fortune 2000 financial services and healthcare companies in America. Decisions is the global software standard for America's greatest brands. Whether you're writing your own applications or using ours, like Tomato and Pear, and whether you're building your own automations or using ours, like financial services flow management and healthcare data integration, Decisions is a software standard for all your needs. The rise of the digital natives like SoFi, Olive, and Flutter, unencumbered by legacy systems, infrastructure, or apparently the need to ever make any money, sharpened by the shock of COVID-19, upended CEO priorities in the world. Openly exposing weaknesses in customer service, business automation, and digital readiness, creating a new CEO imperative, being able to react quickly, if not instantly, to abrupt change in the world. And we all know what makes businesses slow to react, and slow to adapt: siloed business units, manual processes, and the extensive and sometimes exclusive use of Excel to automate work. CEOs have a new call to action: automate anything and everything to break down those barriers and be able to react quickly, if not instantly, to abrupt change. CEOs used to turn exclusively to information technology, to IT, to write applications and build automations. No longer. The shortage of programmers. Who wants to be a programmer for Chase when you can work for Google? Or a programmer for Ohio Health when you can work for Facebook? Well, maybe not Facebook now. Combined with new technologies, has created an explosion in the use of solutions like Decisions. And our customers use our software, our rules engine, workflow manager, and mining agents, and forms, reports, and dashboards to write rules, automate workflows, X-ray their business processes, and design forms, reports, and dashboards to write applications for things like mortgage payments, insurance underwriting, revenue management, and clinical trials management. And they use our software to build automations for customer data management, process approvals, and credit scoring models. And we're making decisions even better for you, building the most capable and most accessible software platform for all your needs. We're extending our process automation lead and leveraging intelligent automation capabilities like artificial intelligence, process mining, machine learning. We're expanding our no-code capabilities and deepening our enterprise capacity to be more secure, more scalable, and easier to deploy. And it's all about confidence, giving more and more customers like you the confidence to use decisions and giving more people, normal people, business people, and information technology professionals, people who know how to solve problems, whether working independently or working together, the confidence to write their own applications and build their own automations to change their world. And people use our platform, our rules engine, workflow manager, and mining agents and forms, reports, and dashboards to write custom software applications. We're doing the same. We're leveraging our platform and writing and launching packaged applications, commercial off-the-shelf applications, products, software products. It's about providing more value to our customers and accelerating our growth. You know we have a great platform and a great market and provide great value to you, our customers, and our growth will happen. Adding products to our platform accelerates the value we provide our customers and our growth, helping us do more for you and grow bigger faster. Tomato Financial is a lending product, including loan origination, loan scoring, and loan servicing. Pear Health is a clinical trials product, including recruiting, enrollment, and monitoring. Imagine a world where getting a loan or approving a loan isn't based just on old-fashioned criteria like credit scores, employment history, and income, but includes lifestyle data, sociometric data, and usage data, and is driven by artificial intelligence and machine learning models. And imagine a world where finding or participating in a clinical trial or running a clinical trial isn't an almost completely manual process, requiring detailed medical expertise, and worse, navigating the intricacies of government-run systems, but is a fully open and transparent and automated process available to everyone. This is the world we're creating with Tomato and Pear, a world where people are more than their credit score and where people take control of their health. As we step back and reflect, the last year has been a year of strength and transformation and growth here at Decisions. As we pursue our end in mind of 1,001 happy customers, 1,001 delighted customers, we've been very fortunate, thanks to our people and thanks to all of you, thanks to our customers, to enjoy record success. We welcomed 80 new customers, 80 new companies to the Decisions family in the last year, including some of America's greatest financial services and healthcare brands. In our quest on the road to 1,001 happy customers, 1,001 delighted customers, we're now more than a quarter of the way to our goal. To support our current and new customers and to power our growth, we added 120 new people to our team in the last year. We've significantly grown our go-to-market team, and departments across the company are all growing. And we've expanded our leadership team with a wonderful combination of both tenured Decisions people and people new to Decisions. Chris and John, Kelly and Kim, David and Tim, Damian, Jocelyn, Pravash, Elise and Janesh, Josiah and Aaron, Brian and AJ, and our friends Heath Hubbard and Brian Phillips are leaders taking Decisions and your customer experience to new levels in the future. And you can be sure as we bring new people, new human beings on board to decisions, the new people fit the decision's way. Like our tenured humans, they live our values, they love our culture, and they are good, very good at their jobs. We launched version 7 of our platform with Postgres and .NET Core support to increase performance and scalability, and with a better user interface and easier form creation to improve usability and your user experience, propelling us forward on our cloud-native journey with a solution to meet the demanding needs of you, our customers. To support you and your needs, we installed new cloud infrastructure and moved into a new and modern data center. We know how important performance, security, and scalability are to you and are committed to an enterprise-grade experience to meet your needs, including earning compliance certification for SOC 2 operational controls and compliance with the PCI DSS security standards. We announced and launched our new Global Operations Center in Hyderabad to formalize our commitment to a global workforce and to bring you the best and the brightest people from around the world. We moved into our new 55,000 square foot headquarters in Virginia Beach, which looks nothing like these renderings that you're seeing on this page. Vision and reality. There's the gap between vision and reality. Plus, you know that's not real because that would say, hey man, it wouldn't say hello if it was reality. Our new headquarters includes a giant training center for you and our people to learn decisions. And our new office does include a new customer center and will include a new customer center when someday it looks like that. If you want to come to our office and write applications or build automations using decisions at our place, and you want to be surrounded by and have availability of the best decisions experts in the business right there all day, every day, we have a workstation for you, and you are welcome anytime at our office to do your work. And we're announcing today Christopher Newport University, CNU, added Management 495, MGMT 495, Business Process Management and Automation to their Spring 22 course catalog. Decisions will be taught to business students by our very own Brian Phillips starting this January. Yeah, all right. Very cool. The last year has been a year of strength, transformation, and growth here at Decisions. And most, the last year has been a year, like for all of us, like it's been for every company and organization around the world, all of us here today, a year to challenge our culture. We're a people-first, product-centric, straight-talk culture. Our cultural norms guide our day-to-day activities, and there are three. Use common sense, exercise good judgment, and follow the 10-minute rule. When you need help, ask. And at our core, there are three pillars to our culture. We love our product, we are excited to deliver value for our customers, and we like each other. Not in the sense of, oh, I like working with Heath. No, for us it's, I like Heath. I like Heath as a person. I like Heath as a human being, and I get to work with him. I get to work with Heath, using our great product to create a lot of cool value for our customers. Our culture, said simply, is people, product, and customers. And it sets the goals for our strategy. And the goals for our strategy are built on the foundations of our culture. People engagement. We want to be the most engaged people in the industry. Product excellence. We have the most capable and accessible product for your needs. And customers, customer experience. You get the best customer experience in the business. Speaking of people, I believe a great CEO transforms industries, organizations, and people, delivering exceptional returns and results to all the people involved. I believe the three qualities of a great CEO are setting a strategy in which people see themselves, driving execution to give people confidence, and building a culture around which people rally. And most, I believe attracting, developing, and retaining people we like, and people with whom we like to work is the one quality that defines the greatest CEOs. The most important job of a president or CEO is appointing vice presidents. It's a weighty responsibility for the president or CEO, and the position of vice president is a serious charge and obligation for the person. The vice presidents make strategy real. They make execution happen. They ensure culture gets nourished, and they attract, develop, and retain people we like and with whom we like to work. The president or CEO delegates the most important parts of the business to the vice presidents. Sales and marketing, which drives growth. Platform and products, the very core of the business. Professional services, which drives customer go-lives. Finance, managing the money of the business. And human resources, which is all about people. Maybe the president or CEO's most important duty is appointing the right vice president of customer service. Superior customer service, as I learned at IBM, is the root of success and is the fabric of our business here at Decisions. Are the customers getting the support they need to be successful? Are you getting the support you need to be successful? Are customers being challenged to get more value from the money they already spend? Are you being challenged to get more value from the money you already spend with us? And are customers benefiting from new tools and training available to them? We have a person here. Oh, man. We have a person here, a human being here today, who is worthy of a promotion to the position of vice president.
We do.
We have a person here, a human being here today, who is worthy, who Heath and I know is worthy to be promoted to the position of vice president. And we have a person here today who Heath and I know that placing the role of customer service ensures our success and all of your success, your future success. And Heath and I are happy to announce, effective today, we are promoting Will Petterson to the position of vice president and to the role of vice president of customer service.
That was not planned. I did not know about this. Thank you.
Will saw my slides before I gave this presentation. There's two versions. There's a version with these comments in it, and there's a version without them. It just says, speaking of people, Will came out to see me 5 minutes before this presentation. He said, in your slides, there's a picture of me, and it says, speaking of people, do I have to do anything? I said, no, I'm just going to say, speaking of people, show a picture of you and move on. And he, congratulations. Well done.
Mr. CEO, job well done, sir.
Yeah, thank you very much.
You're
thank
dispatching you. Your duty.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Now I've totally lost my train of thought. Congratulations, Will. I mean, there are a few people in the world who deserve the promotion to the role. And there are very, very few people in the role who are better than customer service. And it's just wonderful that I get to work with you. It just makes me so proud to work with you. So congratulations again to Will. People, product, and customers. As we think about product, we're launching version 8 of our platform and launching Tomato and Pear this year. So to tell us more about Tomato and Pear, more about our commercial off-the-shelf applications, our products for lending and clinical trials, let's bring up Sean Garcia. Sean is our vice president of applications. He comes from the renowned, the highbrow, the white shoe consulting firm Bain. Sean is a Hampton. Sean is a Hampton Roads native, a normal fellow, a regular human being with a natural leadership bent. Sean loves to collaborate with people. He's great at casting a vision, and you all and we all are in good hands with him leading the team. Sean, give us more information on tomato and pear, please.
Thanks for the introduction, Bob. It's great to be here with all of you. As Bob mentioned, we're leveraging our platform and writing and launching packaged applications, products. We're doing this to provide more value to our customers and to accelerate our growth. Next year, we're launching two packaged off-the-shelf applications, Tomato and Pear. Tomato Financial is a lending product, including loan origination, loan scoring, and loan servicing. And Pear Health is a clinical trials product, including recruitment, enrollment, and monitoring. Let's take a closer look at each, starting with Tomato. The world of lending is changing. For the last 30 years, the same four factors have dominated credit decisions. Of course, a person's credit score, income, some sort of debt-to-income ratio, and work history. But today, in 2021, data is everywhere. And so what if we could create a world where credit decisions can be reached with any and all data? Imagine a world where bank statements, cell phone usage, your digital footprint, your driving records could be plugged into a decisions rules engine to create a completely custom credit scoring engine. And what if that scoring engine could be adjusted for market conditions within a second? And what if that model got better at predicting lending outcomes due to machine learning and AI? We are building the lending platform for this world, helping lenders write the smartest loans and helping borrowers become more than their credit score. Tomato Financial is coming in the next year. On the healthcare side, the world of clinical trials has long been hampered by inefficient recruiting and enrollment, costing pharmaceutical companies millions of dollars in delays, and more importantly, preventing people from finding treatments that could change their lives. Manual processes, unstructured data, and government-run websites have created a jumbled web that caused frustration and delays. Delays for people who need life-changing treatment the most. And so with Pear Health, our goal is to help launch clinical trials in minutes, not months. We are using the Decisions platform to ingest patient health records and to structure clinical trial protocols, allowing us to automate patient and clinical trial matching. With Pear, pharmaceutical companies no longer need to manually scrub records to find qualified patients, and those looking for treatment now have the power to find cutting-edge help at their fingertips. Pear is coming in 2023. Back to you, Bob.
Thank you, Sean. Well done. People, product, and customers. Today, we launch the Decisions Developer Community. Our goal, our end in mind, is for you, for all of you, to get more value out of the money you spend with us. And all of you are members of the Decision Developer Community, and we will enable, we will empower, and we will expand the community. We are coming out with a new training curriculum. We will help you use the latest tools, meaning getting you to the latest release of our platform, and help you use decisions for more and more use cases, solving more and more problems across your business. To tell us more about the Decisions Developer Community, let's bring up our friend, Gordon Jones. Yes. Gordon Jones has been with Decisions for 9 years now, 9 years, not 8 years, 9 years now, 4 years as a customer, and 5 years working here. You all know the words to describe Gordon Jones: determined, motivated, responsible, passionate, sincere, helpful, calm, cool, collected. The word used most often to describe Gordon Jones is a word used sparingly in this world, a word hard to earn, and a word that describes Gordon Jones perfectly. And that word is trustworthy. Ladies and gentlemen, Gordon Jones.
Well, thanks for the kind words, Bob. Bob has spoken eloquently about the why and the what of Decisions, and I'm going to talk a bit about the how through the Decisions developer community. But before I do, I'm going to share with you all that, you know, when COVID started 2 years ago, we, on a Friday, we said, all right, everybody go home. On Monday morning, we said, look, let's all get on a Zoom meeting at 8:30 for 2 weeks, right? And here we are 18 months later. Well, one neat thing that happened during that morning meeting is, and we've continued it since then, and one of the things we've done recently is start to share use cases in that morning meeting. And Bob talked to some of them here. I mean, we talk about them a lot in Decisions. You know, he mentioned Coke trading. So they do trade reconciliation, so they do 2 million commodity trades a day, and then they run those across 500 rules. So we're talking billions of transactions a day across the rules engine. Roche Genentech, they're using Decisions to add metadata to clinical trial test results all across the globe. And they'll be using that in the future for drug discovery and potentially even patient-less clinical trials. And then we do more mundane stuff, like Arizona Department of Transportation calculates people's vehicle tax. So just reliably doing, you know, day-to-day automations. But it doesn't have to be the big, hairy problem. Now, most customers come to us with these big, hairy problems, but it doesn't have to, Decisions doesn't have to do just that. It can do more. And we have some sessions here over the next couple days to talk about a lot of these use cases. One of these sessions, or one of our clients, rather, Blue Energy, you know, they're an energy company. They text people when the power goes out to save everybody from calling in. And they have about 30 or 40 additional small little automations like that. Rio Tinto uses us to collect data from different websites, small little automations, pull data, and dump it into a database. But my favorite, and this is where I'm circling back to our morning meeting, we typically ask people what their favorite use case is of the day. And my favorite use case of today is John Gogarty here. John was sharing me last night that he's used Decisions to integrate with Yahoo Fantasy Football and send emails out to his team members for selection and that. So if any of you are interested in Decisions integration to Yahoo Fantasy Football, let's reach out to John. Now, the way that this comes about is people who learn Decisions and at a certain point get it, and then find ways to do all of these little and big automations. And the way that you get there is through training, and is Brian Phillips. Brian, and could the Decisions training team stand up? So they'll have a booth out here, and we have a lot to talk about with training, so I only have about a minute or two left, but what I am going to highlight is that we've completely revamped the training program. And And as of October 18th, the next training cycle on our website, which you all can sign up for, we no longer have like internal training for our decisions employees and a series of external trainings for customers. It's all one. So we've totally revamped our training program, which is now one training path for internal employees and customers, partners. So you'll be sitting alongside, if you attend at the office, which you're welcome to, or online, you'll be right next to our decisions employees and customers and partners. And we've revamped it. It runs in like a 6-week sprint. And as Bob always says, no code does not mean no training. So we solve complicated problems that requires training. And many of you have purchased decisions because you saw through the sales process that in a couple days, a week's time, we can turn around a very complicated solution in a short period of time. And the way that happens is with fully trained decisions developers. So we have a lot that we've changed and that you'll see in the first class on the 18th, and we have a lot planned in the future. We're investing in a learning management system. We're doing weekly lunch and learns, Monday through Thursday. So if you're already developing in decisions, I want to highlight the fact that you can join us every day at lunch and bring your questions. And on the other end of the phone, we'll have experienced decisions developers that can help you out. So a lot of exciting stuff to talk about with training. I'd invite you all to come visit the training booth out in the hall. And I would highly encourage you to send your team of developers through our training. It's free. Just sign up online, join us. It's a 6-week, if you can do it contiguously, or you can do it a week at a time over the course of 6 months. But we'd want you to get it done within a 6-month period. They're done in sprints. Each one builds on the last. And we reached out to our own professional services team and our architects to ensure that what's being trained covers the whole product and its real life use cases. So we've got healthcare, we've got financial services use cases that are done in 1-week sprints. And I think you'll all enjoy it. Thanks, back to you, Bob.
So people, product, and customers, and let us end where we started with people. I am, and we are proud to announce that joining us today as her first day, as her very first day at Decisions, is our new head of human resources, Kristin Dabney. You all know, yes, please. You all know how important people are to our business and how important people are to your success. And you all know Decisions is built on the strength, it's built on the character, and it's built on the passions of people. And you all know our culture starts with the words, people first. And our culture ends with the words, we like each other. The bar, the standard for our new human resources leader is very, very, very high. And Kristin rises to that standard with her commitment to people, her passion for leadership, and her dead funny and wonderful personality. She's a perfect fit for us, and we'll make sure all of you, our customers, continue to be surrounded by great people at Decisions. And that's Decisions, people, product, and customers. The last year has been a year of strength, transformation, and growth. The year ahead is about making our product more capable and more accessible for you, launching new applications, Tomato and Pear, and helping you be successful by growing the Decisions developer community. And of course, the year ahead is about making even more connections as people, even more connections as human beings with all of us and all of you. Decisions, one complete solution for all your software needs, is the global software standard for Fortune 2000 financial services and healthcare companies in America. Decisions is the global software standard for America's greatest brands. Whether you're writing your own applications or using ours, and whether you're building your own automations or using ours, Decisions is the software standard for all your needs. Thank you for being our customer. Thank you to every one of you for being our customer. Thank you for all the Decisions people who gathered here today. I look forward to our future together. Thank you. Okay, that was my formal CEO address. Pretty formal, pretty CEO-like. I feel better now, I'm totally relaxed. Thank you all to you for making me feel relaxed. I'm gonna introduce our next speaker. And the way I'm gonna introduce our next speaker is to remind all of you that all of us have these moments in our lives that change our lives. And many of you can remember the moments that change your lives and the dates. Like, I can remember the dates. February 17th, 1977. February 17th, 1977. I was a 16-year-old boy. My parents, I was a junior in high school, and my parents had moved from Mount Vernon, Ohio, which was a small town in Ohio surrounded by the cornfields of central Ohio, to Lexington, Ohio, which was an even smaller town in north central Ohio surrounded by the soybean fields of north central Ohio. I was a 16-year-old boy, junior year in high school. Halfway through my junior year, and we switched. My parents moved, and I switched high schools. I was not happy. This was not a good experience for me. This was not a pleasant thing to be doing, is switching schools in the middle of my junior year. And I was 16. I was a boy. I was totally ill-equipped. I'm ill-equipped to deal with it today, much less when I was 16 years old. I was so distraught, and I was so upset, but something happened to me that day. That was my first day in that school. I walked into the front door of Lexington High School in Lexington, Ohio. I turned left down the corridor. I was going to Dr. David Oswald's world history class in room 101, and there at locker 104 was a girl. Blonde haired girl, page boy haircut, white shirt, blue pants, white socks, tan bucks. Biggest, brightest smile you've ever seen in your life. Boom, I was struck. She had no idea who I was. She didn't recognize me, even notice me for a while. I was struck by that person. That's Mary Beth. That was Mary Beth Holland, Mary Beth Irwin, now my wife. She was 15, I was 16. We haven't been together since she was 15 and 16. It took me a while to stalk her, to get her attention. But stalk her I did, and stalk her I still do, to get her attention. February 17th, 1977. August 10th, 1981, I was 20 years old. I was a junior at the Ohio State University. I got a job at IBM as an intern. August 10th, 1981 was my first day at IBM. I met a guy that day, his name was Mark Young. He was my manager. I was an intern, he was my manager. His name was Mark Young. Mark Young said to me, sit next to that person and here's your job. And the person I sat next to was a lady named Sherry McFadden. Years later, Mark Young and Sherry McFadden started dating. Years later, Mark Young and Sherry McFadden got married. Years later, Mark Young and Sherry McFadden had a baby, Adam. 5 years later, Mary Beth and I had a baby, Elle. And today, baby Adam and baby Elle are husband and wife. Mark's son is my son-in-law, married to my daughter. August 10th, 1981. July 27th, 2020. I reported to work my very first day as a Decisions employee. The first person to greet me was Heath Oderman with a firm handshake. Since that day, we started a great partnership. Since that day, we started a great friendship. And to this day, on this day, I love Heath Oderman for the man he is, for what he represents to all of us. And our next speaker is Heath Oderman.